while my son was being born, I was out singing freedom songs behind a mule-drawn caisson in memory of Dr. Martin Luther King. We shall overcome. We shall. They can't never kill his voice. On the night of his death, black folks were burning buildings in New Orleans. Me and three of my bus driver friends was cruising around town in a new yellow Mustang. We saw a white boy walking on the sidewalk near the St. Bernard housing project, and we hollered, "Hey, you bitch motherfucker." The white boy came out of his pocket with a pistol, and he started shooting and running. We started ducking and trucking, but we ain't had a safety pin to fight back with. We shall overcome. We shall overcome someday.
California to a shotgun-shaped house in New Orleans, Louisiana. Oh,
the pigs. We were shooters, shot at that house. A near-sighted old dog defended our yard, watching them, sending us a big bushy-haired brother to set us up. We were shooters in a shotgun house. A Chevy full of feds set across our street, watching us, watch our old dog Spot chase that colored lady cop. Get to Uncle Tom. Get to Uncle Tom, people. Get to Uncle Tom. We gonna kill all the black is first. Expected revolution that created a newfound love between brothers living in a different housing projects in New Orleans. If you're going to be a member of the Black Panther Party, you've got to stop fighting your brother just because you don't live in the same government housing project as you, or the same ward as you. If you hear a brother talking about from the nine and he don't mind dying, he's talking about dying for the revolution now. We ain't acting stupid no more. The party encourages us to read a book a day. We also learning how to clean and break down our guns. You will lose your life, my mother says. I done already lost my wife and my three children. Bus company fired me. The Harper Police Department forced me to resign because I wasn't arresting nobody. Can't be a pig and a panda at the same time. And the only reason why I'm driving this taxi horse is because I don't have a car right now. And I need me a ride through this expected revolution. But as far as work goes, it's like a brother from Dan Poison who leads the meeting at the Panthers headquarters state. What you wanna do? Punch the man or punch the clock? I say bring on the man, boss. And the man coming? Yeah. Cause J. Edgar Hoover done declared the party to be the nation's chief security threat. You lost your mind, my mother say. But Rita Newton said that Master took my mind when he took my manhood. And that if I could take my manhood back, then I'd get my mind back by any means necessary. By any means necessary. Pigs raided my mother's house, boss. And a half hour searched it before I turned in a search warrant before I could stop them. But they still ain't found shit. No gun, no money, no nothing. But they still took me and my taxi to jail and charged me with armed robbery. I done been to trial. I got a mistrial. Now they offered me a deal on being guilty to simple robbery. I feel like telling them to stick it up their ass. But my mother done busted her ass long enough in the white folks' kitchen to hire me a lawyer for my first trial. And I ain't gonna put it through that no more. So I'm copping out to 30 months in Angola penitentiary. Angola, boss. That a bitch? Why couldn't they name it wrong? Angola, but it was me all. Penitentiary in Louisiana called Angola, shackled to druggists I knew nothing about. Trucked fields where grass abounds. A khaki plaid cracker unlocks iron from our ankles. And he is insulting us. You gotta understand. Ain't going to penitentiary, don't try to make nothing easy for you. He shouts to my shoe as I look at his holster pistol. The judge said, hard labor, and this cracker is enforced. And he is insulting us. Grab a hook and stand two to a rope. If you want to run, nigger, run. As long as you have my gun, you will keep up with rope number one. Standing behind rope number one is a greasy black inmate guard with a shotgun. He spits out tobacco juice just like his boss. Will kill you quicker than his boss. And he too is insulting us. Cut my grass, leave my greens. Pour that row, you so-and-so. Show me what you got, row number one. And there are 200 on row number one, going so fast. But I have no problem catching row number one. Because I come from peace work on plantations. And I know how to cut the grass, leave the greens, and chop the dirt that's in between. But my robot, he handles his hole like a bitch. And I ain't helping him. Because he is my brother. Then an old count on nine, the road next to mine, says, you can have that boy and I'll let you carry him. I say, no, thank you, sir, because I just can't see myself shackled to a bad relationship. So I keep on helping him shave the grass. But when we get back to lockdown and he finds a love letter on his bunk, I can't save that ass. I know why the snakes left the dirt, but they tried me when I was a fish. And when they say, shit on my dick, or blood on my shank, I say, kill me, motherfucker, because my man is the last meal until I die. I got to rise with the sun. I got to keep up with what ain't no good. Two more summers and I'll be gone. Good freedom feels until you lose it, boss. I ain't never going back to jail no more. That place kicked my ass, physically and mentally. I'll be walking around New Orleans now with no particular destination in mind. I just be walking around watching the birds and looking at storefront windows. One day while I'm looking at the storefront window on Rampart Street, a sign said, free shoes. A black man got up from his desk and came to talk to me. He said, you look like you're dressed pretty nice, so what's your problem? I told him that I'd just gotten out of the joint. Then he asked me about my education. I said, I'm a high school graduate. He said, if you had a chance to further your education, what would you do? Well, like most black folks I know, I said, I want to have my own business. He took that bad business off my mind and sent me to see a little white lady counselor. He sent me to see a psych doctor. He sent me back to her saying that I was suited for sales and approved for school. So she asked me what I wanted to do. Without hesitation, I said, I want to be a writer. So now it's going to take me too long to be a writer. So I thought about my love of music. All the tunes I was sung along with the radio. One summer night.